Hi, everybody, and I am Phyllis Frase, Charrette, and I am here today with PSI TV and our wonderful guest, and we're going to be talking about Allstate Business Solutions, and our two guests are Jeff and Monica. Jeff, if you can please tell us a little bit about what you do with Allstate.
Be glad to. My name's Jeff Baird. I own the Baird Insurance Agency. Obviously, I'm with Allstate, associated with Allstate Insurance, and my office is located in Frisco, Texas. And we take care of customers across 11 states.
Awesome. And Monica, thanks for joining us.
Good to be back. My name is Monica Jenkins. I am a senior commercial business consultant, and I work with Allstate agents to help them understand a little bit more about commercial insurance and ensuring that we are taking care of our customers the way they should be taken care of.
Awesome. And I know when we think of Allstate, what do most people think about?
The good hands.
The good hands, the car insurance, yes. The homeowner's insurance. But you guys are very unique in the fact that you have a specific policies and a specific niche for chiropractors.
Absolutely. And business owners in general for the most part, but chiropractors is a specialty for us. We have our business shield policy that we have designed specifically for the medical insurance professions.
Awesome. And I think that's great because in our last podcast, we talked about all the different ways that you could insure a medical office,
yes,
and or chiropractic offices. But today I think you guys came to talk about something very specific that is a concern to all service industries, and that's talking about cybersecurity, right?
Absolutely.
Correct. Yeah, yes. That's a big concern these days.
Now, do you think, I know with me being in the chiropractic profession and working in chiropractic offices, how often when you visit with chiropractors and insure chiropractors, how often do they really think about cybersecurity?
I think that's one of the reasons why we're here and one of the biggest topics, because they don't realize the impact that cybersecurity can have on their daily practice, the impact that it has on the potential impact that it has on their patients. And so going through today, we're going to talk about the three basically specific coverages within cyber as a whole that will help the practice itself as well as help protect their patients' information.
Wow. Because I know when I worked in offices, you know, the technology yeah. is not what it is today, and it changes every day. So why don't you tell me one of the specific points about cybersecurity and how important that is to chiropractors to really look at that at their policy?
Well, I think the number one thing that jumps out at you is identity theft. Mm-hmm. And no one in the business world probably has as much personal information on file as someone in the medical field. So identity theft is probably the number one thing that would jump out at you. There's a couple other components to the whole cyber insurance piece, but identity theft is probably the number one thing that would jump out at someone.
Okay, now there is a difference because we know of the HIPAA regulations as far as medical information, as far as treatment and, you
history.
Know, history mm-hmm. and things like that. But that's what you're talking about is different than that.
Absolutely. You know, thinking to my own personal chiropractor that I go to, you know, I never sit out there and pay on a per visit basis. They have everything on file.
Okay.
Via credit card, via, you know, some people use electronic banking, so they'll have your routing and account number. So they have your personal banking credit card information on file 90% of the time, as you know, a lot of folks do pay out of pocket for that type of service and their daily visits.
So this isn't just an issue for big retailers.
No, not at all. And you know, you had mentioned earlier that technology has changed, and so has the advancement of breach of technology. And so that's the bigger concern, because the businesses don't have the millions and millions of dollars to protect their computer integrity or their data integrity, and that's where cyber attacks are very real for your businesses.
And I think it's important. That's why we have the personal relationship with the clients mm-hmm. that we do, because when you say the big retailers, the big companies, they've got big technology support behind them. When you're a small business owner, you don't have that big technology support team behind you, so it's important that you have the proper coverage in case that breach occurs.
Okay. Because I know that my debit card has been compromised several times in other places, and it's also a very inconvenient for the customer or a patient. And I know all our great chiropractors, they're into taking care of their patients, and this may not even register in their mind that this is something that they need to really consider. Does normal business liability insurance cover this, and how are you different in that aspect?
So it covers it to a degree, but when we go down to, so we talked about the three things that encompass cyber. So there's data compromise, there's the identity theft of it, and then there's actually what we have called Cyber One coverage. So each one has a component that is specialized. So does it cover overall? There is a piece of it, but depending on the size of the business, you're going to want to have bigger limits. There's first party and there's third party coverage. So if it happens to Jeff's office or a doctor's office, they're going to have to pay a claim or basically state a claim for their own policy. That would be first party coverage. Okay. Third party is if one of the patients said, hey, my credit card was stolen or my identity was stolen, I'm going to bring action against you. That's third-party coverage. Okay. So because there's differences among all of them, it does take, again, like we talked about last time, a true sit-down conversation. And I know with Jeff's chiropractor, he talked about how just technology advanced they are. With he walks in, he has a little card, he swipes it, and, I mean, it's just when technology takes over, there's a big risk.
Okay.
Absolutely. And, again, with identity theft, that we're talking about the patient. Mm-hmm. There's the physician side of it. There's the chiropractor side of it that they have risk involved as well with lost income and things along those lines. So, again, it compromises three key issues with identity theft, the data compromise, and then the whole Cyber One coverage.
Okay, so when there is a loss of business, mm-hmm. how does that policy come into effect for that? So give an example of that.
So let's say you get an email from a patient and it has a link, and you're thinking that link has more information to their workers' comp, to some medical information that you need for billing purposes or treatment purposes. If you click on that link and that actually ends up being malware, and it gets into your system, then it could wipe out your appointments, it could wipe out your database. At that point, you are no longer able to send your patients reminders of their appointments. So you could lose income that way. If a patient comes in and you can't access their medical records and you don't have paper records and you go, I'm really not sure how I'm supposed to treat you or the next step in the treatment, that's lost income. So because the policy triggers, the coverage triggers that, I guess, loss of income, the policy would, coverage would reimburse you for that lost income.
And when you're a business owner, everything's income. Everything's right. Your net revenue. And so the last piece of it is the Cyber One coverage, because the virus may be so severe, it may get so infiltrated into the system that the system has to be replaced. And that's where the Cyber One piece of it comes in. So we're talking lost wages, we're talking data compromise with the identity theft, and then we're talking about maybe damage to the software systems that you have in place, because again, I'm blown away with the technology that my chiropractor has. And so if his systems go down and things have to be replaced, it gets costly, and it gets costly in a hurry.
And if they can't access their patient's records, then they're also maybe compromising the patient's care.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And if they're not willing, if they're not willing to take care of that patient, then the patient has to return, and it's an inconvenience. And
for
the patient
involved.
Can't mm-hmm. get taken care of.
Absolutely. And
wow.
And we want to make sure that, you know, we want to make sure, again, as you talked about at the beginning of our conversation, that the customer's in good hands, that the chiropractic association that we deal with and the Parker alumni that we deal with, they care every bit as much as we do as for their patients. So absolutely. That way everybody stays well taken care of in that situation.
And that brings us to the next point that you guys will be joining us in October for our Dallas Seminar Homecoming event, because you guys are sponsors with us. And so I know that you guys are preparing things as a show special, whether it's evaluating someone's current policy that they can bring to you in our exhibit
Absolutely.
Area. Anything that you would like to share before we close this podcast out as far as what you do and who you are and how you serve our Parker community.
Well, we're really excited about being part of the show. I'm really excited about that. We're going to have two booths at this show, so we're going to have a large area. We're going to have full support. So if somebody comes in with either their current insurance policy or they have specific questions, we're going to have enough people there to really talk about the coverages that they may need or they may want to look to discuss further in detail. Jeff and his team will be there. I'll be there.
And we love being involved because as we talk about with cyber, this and technology, a lot of times you feel like you become this disconnected world.
Right.
This event that you're hosting,
yes,
it allows us to be connected to your team, to your alumni, to your student body. And that's what we love, being involved, connected, doing whatever we can.
Face-to-face,
personal relationships, because that gets lost in this sometimes. And it's still important to me. I know that.
Yeah, well, that's great. Well, we appreciate all the things that you do, participating in our career fair and doing our vendor spotlights with our students so that we can give them information so that when they go into practice that they'll be successful and they know what they need to do and what they need to have. And if someone wants to reach out to you before the seminar to start that, because you always do a complimentary evaluation looking over insurance policies for chiropractors at no charge, correct?
Correct.
Okay. And so we will make that information available to everybody.
Do. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Thank
okay.
you.
Well, once again, thank you for joining with us at PSI TV, because our faith, confidence, and belief creates our products, services, and ideas. And we'll see you again.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.